revelation, progressive revelation. We see in the beginning, it was herb. Then he make them begin to eat meat. And then he make a distinction between the clean and the unclean. Amen. I won't read all of it because it's a long text. Amen. But because of time, you can read this in your own quiet time. Amen. But what God was saying in Deuteronomy, he was basically commanding them what to eat. Amen. He was commanding them what to eat. Progressive revelation. Progressive revelation. Jesus said, you are clean because of the word I've spoken unto you. You got to understand, there is power in the word of God. Time and time again, people say prayer changes things. Yeah. Don't we all say that? That prayer changes things. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Water. Mere water. Amen. The moment it's being prayed over by a minister of God, it becomes something else. Hallelujah. It becomes holy water. Amen. That can work wonders. Yes, can work wonders. And Amen. Daddy is a witness to that. Amen.
Yes.
Daddy be a witness to that.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. The moment you pray over the water, it becomes something else.
Hallelujah.
Mere water become holy water because why? It is sanctified by the word of God and Amen. Prayer.
Hallelujah.
Not one jot, not tittle shall pass from the law till all be fulfilled. And we see that fulfillment on the cross
Amen.
When Jesus said it is finish.
Yes.
It Amen. Is finish. Colossians 2:13-17. Sister Paulette, Colossians 2:13-17. It is sanctified by the word of God and prayer.
Colossians 2.
Yes, please. 13-17. Are you there?
13-17.
Praise God.
Praise God. Praise God. Colossians 2:17-13.
Yeah, please.
Praise God. I'm looking at it, but it's not coming up. Okay. And you, being dead in your trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, he has made alive together with him, having forgotten you all trespasses, having wiped out the handwriting of requirements that was against us, which was contrary to us, and he has taken it out of the way, having nailed it to the cross, having disarmed principalities and powers, he made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them in it. So let no one judge you in food or in drink, or regarding a festival, or a new moon, or Sabbath, which are a shadow of things to come, but the substance is of Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen. But the body is of Christ.
Hmm.
The word that God said, we were called unto liberty. So in Christ, we are no longer bound by the law. What I'm trying to highlight is the power in the Word of God to change things. Prayer change things. We are children of faith. We are the seed of Abraham. And the Bible said, without faith, it is impossible to please God.
Amen.
We know that the Gentiles were viewed as inferior compared to the Jews. Jesus said, it is not right. And this is Jesus speaking. It is not right to take the children's bread and cast it to the dogs. That sounds a bit harsh. But it was Jesus who was speaking. And basically he was saying to the Canaanite woman, she was like a dog in comparison to the Jews. Dogs were viewed as unclean beasts when compared to sheep. But in spite of what Jesus said, she still persists until she gets what she came for. Amen. Amen. May you persist, persevere, until you get what you desire from the Lord. In the name of Jesus. I don't know what it is that you are hoping to receive from the hand of the Lord. But I can tell you this. I can tell you the truth. To them that believe, all things are possible. In Genesis, when God created and he made them, the bird, the fish, the beast of the field, and so on, he said it was good. Everything God made was good. Jesus said, it is not that which goes into a man that defile him. And I believe he was speaking about meat and drink also. Not only because they didn't wash their hand, or they washed their hand before eating. Not that which enter in, but that which proceed from the man. That's what defile the man. For out of the earth proceed evil things, and that's what defile the man. I hope I am making sense where this message is concerned. When I'm saying that it is sanctified by the word of God and by prayer. I said the Jews pray. I said the Muslim pray. The Hindus pray. The Buddhist pray. But only the Christian, the believer, use the word of God. And that is the distinction between prayer and the word of God. Because it's the word of God that will give you access to the throne room of grace. And Jesus is the Word of God.
Hallelujah.
And the last Bible reading is taken from the book of Romans. And I think I need to read that Bible text. Romans 1 or Romans 14. And I'm reading from verse 1, going down. Amen?
Amen.